Hello everybody. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use ChatGPT to correct the spelling and punctuation inside of a .srt or other caption file. So in this example, I've downloaded the automatic captions from a YouTube video I made, and here they are. And if you look at them, they're okay. They just don't have any punctuation really. So there's no commas, there's no periods, there's some issues here. Canvas Studio, for instance, this is a brand and tool name, so that should be capitalized. So there's a lot of kind of things that could be cleaned up. So I'm going to get ChatGPT to fix it for me. So the first step, after you've downloaded your SRT file, and you don't have to own the video yourself. You can use a third-party website to download the SRT file. Just do that at your own risk. I don't endorse any of those websites. But once you have that file, you're going to go into ChatGPT and use the following prompt. Please correct the spelling and punctuation in the following SRT file text without changing the timings or structure. Do not combine any lines. Please output your response in a code block. And we're going to use quotation marks. And then you're only going to paste the first 25 lines of your file, because I found if you do the whole file, sometimes ChatGPT gets the first part right and then it messes up or stops generating. So I like to do 25 lines at a time. So I'll show you what that does. So if we scroll down, so you can see ChatGPT has said, here's the corrected text in a code block without changing the timings or structure. And right away you can tell they've added an exclamation point, capital letter on hello everybody, some commas in here. They've capitalized the word canvas and studio. That was an issue before. And it's pretty good. Looks good on this end. One thing I do like to do is kind of a spot check. So you can open up your caption file side by side and just check the bottom one, 25. I like to check the bottom one. Make sure that the timings are identical, 105. And it says 105 to 110 to 110. And the text is, you like to do it that way, period, once your, and that looks like it's got that down. And you can even see, like when I say Command V in the video, it's put the little plus there. So it's great that it does all this for me. And the reason I like to output it in this code block is it's plain text. You can just click this copy code. It's not going to copy any weird formatting. I find if you use this and then paste into an SRT file, it works perfectly. So what I'm going to do is just copy the first 25 lines and paste in that updated code. So now it's corrected for spelling and punctuation. And then we'll do the next 25. So I'll go 26 down to 50. And I'm going to highlight that. I'm going to redo that prompt again. Paste that prompt in. Put in the quotation marks. Copy the next 25. And just repeat this action here. And there it goes. It's doing those. And we'll do a spot check at 50. And it looks pretty good. 50 ends at 210 to 215, which is exactly what it does here. So I'm going to go ahead and copy using that copy code button, click into my SRT file and paste it in. So that's pasted over top of the old ones. And what I like to do is actually go to the one that started. So this one I started at 26, and just because ChatGPT didn't really know that this was a continuation from 25. That's where I'm going to make a little adjustment here. So you can see that it says once your link has, once your link is pasted, is the dialogue here. I'm going to just make that link lowercase, the word link. Okay, so this is fantastic. I don't know if you're looking at the corrections it's made, but I'm very impressed. So a lot of times the auto captions have a problem when you're reading out like a file. So in this case, I say .srt, and actually ChatGPT did it correctly. Each time I said it, it knew what I was talking about. Also, again, the tool Canvas Studio gave that capital letters. It's given quotation marks when I say stuff like this. You can see it says change is saved. I just really am blown away by the amount of time this has saved me just from having to correct captions. So let's go ahead and save this corrected file. And we'll go into, in this case, YouTube is where I need to upload the corrected one. And I'm going to go ahead and upload it. And we'll publish it. And let's just watch the video a little bit and see. So I'm just looking at the captions at the bottom. And you can tell right away that these have been corrected. That's amazing. That took me a very short amount of time to fix the spelling and grammar on this. Anyways, thanks for watching.